I want to get us going. It's now 9:30, and I know that the usual starting time over the years has been 11 o'clock. But we are changing our whole format as of this year, kicking off early, contracting the conference to within 3 days, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, having our early morning walk, run, the 5K, 10K. I see a lot of young people here. I trust they have walked with their rubber shoes for Saturday morning, and we will close off the conference Saturday evening without having any spillover into the Sunday morning. There are still a number outside who are getting registered, but as I explained to Minister, we won't wait because we know his timetable takes him here, there, and everywhere in short spaces of time. This year, our focus is going to be taking us on a very interesting collaboration between the diabetes world and the oral health world. And it is a part of this why I think we see a lot of white coats in front of me. Those who are from the College of Oral Health Sciences, who have traveled over by bus this morning, let us see you. Hands up. A special welcome to you all. Those of you who are pursuing the DMD program, Doctor of Mental Dentistry, let me see your hands. Okay. The dental technologists or dental assistants, dental nursing, let me see your hands. So, Minister, in front of you are all those who are following in your footsteps. As is customary, there's a thing called Caribbean time for our visitors from afar off, but our usual first order of business is to take a roll call of those who are with us. And I do suspect that a fair amount of our members from across the region will be trundling in due course. But nonetheless, let me just see who are gathered here at this point. Any out of Belize? I can't see over this side, you know, so you must shout. Belize? No. Cayman? Cuba? Cuba? I saw some outside, no? Where is Cuba? Oh, beg your pardon, that light is blinding me. Welcome, Dominican Republic. Haiti, outside, okay. Where we go, Puerto Rico, Antigua, shout for me now, because I'm totally blinded. Antigua, man, Dominica, St. Lucia, St. Vincent, Barbados, Trinidad, well, the Trinidads always make a lot of noise, you know. So we always know when they're here. Welcome, Trinidads. And as you will notice that we're trying to get back onto a, you know, rollicking Caribbean night tomorrow evening. You'll hear more about that. They have always insisted, you know, Minister, they can't come from Trinidad and don't get into a little bit of soca. Yeah. I see some, yes? Tobago, beg your pardon. How can I ever commit such a grievous error? Trinidad and the Tobagonians, welcome. As we go on, Grenada, stand up on the table, man. Special welcome. Guyana. All right. Which ones have I missed out? Turks and Caicos. Suriname. All right. Which ones have I left out that are here represented? Aruba, Curacao. Welcome. My geography is not so good, you know. I didn't do so well at school today. So you must forgive me. Aruba, Curacao, and Bonaire. Bahamas, I said that at the beginning. You came in late. Welcome. Where's Bahamas? Let me see you. Bahamas? St. Kitts Nevis? Anguilla? What are you? I see your hand. Anguilla? Let us see you now. Stand up. That is the Anguilla Diabetes Association. Welcome. We said Grenada, but any others? Montserrat is still has inhabitants, eh? No, you know that they, I think most of them were ordered evacuated after that volcanic eruption. Okay, to the North American continent and Canada. Welcome. USA? There? Okay, I see. I'm totally blinded. Welcome. And we had mentioned Mexico before. Any from Central America that we have left out? Panama, Costa Rica, Salvador? None? We are looking forward to some Panamanians, you know. We are talking to them on other matters related to their canal. And we got a commitment that a number of their medical team might very well be with us this morning. But those are gathered here, and I didn't really ask for Jamaica because we saw our students earlier, but nonetheless, let us hear a raucous shout from the Jamaicans sitting in the audience. There was cornmeal porridge for breakfast, you know. Well, it's good to have you, and we look forward to these 3 days of working together and learning together. As you would have been seeing in the booklet, we have full days, and we're so pleased in particular, Minister, that we have our students, our dental students, presenting in one particular session of some of the work that they have been doing and plan to do under the title Brush Up Jamaica. One of the things that we have been priding ourselves on, not only from the diabetes point of view, where, as you know, since 1976, we have been doing outreaches, working in the communities, educating individuals how best to look after themselves, because it's the protection that really is the cost-effective way of looking after that particular malady. And through the Diabetes Association and the University of the West Indies in the early 90s, we kicked off this set of conferencing, and this has grown in strength over the years and encompassed the Northern Caribbean University and the University of Technology. Northern Caribbean had a little challenge, but they are certainly back on. By the time they contacted us this year, it was too late to get them on the banner. but they are certainly back with us with a bang. And the three main universities are very much collaborating in this diabetes outreach education that is the key to the management of the condition. And this year in particular, you'll be hearing much about the Oral Health Trust, and I've been learning myself even in the launch of this particular conference a couple of weeks back at the College of Oral Health Sciences, how critical oral health care is to the diabetic story. So this year, we're focusing on that. And you'll soon be seeing the man behind the helm who has made all of this possible. And Minister, I know you have him sitting on your right, on your right side, but without him being at UTech's right side as well, I don't think any of this would have been possible. I don't see him, because he's usually quite easy to see. But where is Prof. Irvin McKenzie? Where is he? And his team, Dr. Boyd, I think you were here. Any other members of the team? Faculty from the college? Ah, welcome, welcome. Those are members of the team there. Glad to have you. And I know there's another bus on the way. In short order, you will evict me from this platform as you take over this conference fully. I want to, however, give notice. As you know, UTech is the premier institution for sports in Jamaica. And the rest of the Caribbean looks to UTech and its tremendous sport program that has been developed since the 1970s. And it is as a result of much of that that many of the other institutions at the tertiary level, and we now have a relatively strong intercollegiate sporting program. And we want to give a special recognition to the University of Technology in leading the way. And I'm saying that to say that next year, we will be looking at diabetes and sport. A very important combination, which we think we will use to highlight the lifestyle that's so important, especially amongst the young, and thereafter, even after their sporting days, what they need to do to ensure the quality of life and the protection against the development of chronic illnesses like diabetes. And we hope to have a number of luminaries to point out just that fact. Whilst they were actively training and involved in sport, they were fine. And later on, as they started to reduce their physical activity, drank a few more beers, got a little bit of pot belly, and goodness me, diabetes was very much on the horizon. So next year we're going to be looking at that, and I want to say a special welcome to Professor Colin Giles, Dean of the Faculty of Science and Sport. He's here with his team looking at how we do this thing, because he takes over the conference next year as we look at diabetes and sport. So it is in that context then that we want to just say a special welcome to you this morning. And during the course of the day, you will be hearing of the various activities that the conference is putting on. This evening, at the end of conference, I think it's 5:30, we're having welcome cocktails by the Lighthouse. You'll be directed there. Welcome cocktails that will go on for a couple of hours. Tomorrow evening, we have the Caribbean Night at Laughing Waters. So inquire at the registration desk, get your invitations. It's all included in your registration packages. So we look forward to your coming and being fully entertained, steel band, music, fashion show, all kinds of things going on. Trin, is you hearing? And there shall be enough soca for you to do some exercise. And yes, dance exercise. And Saturday morning at 6 o'clock, so even although we're partying on Friday night, you're all young enough, we're looking forward to your turning up for 6 o'clock for the 5K, 10K run walk, which will set us right for the lectures which begin at 10:30 on Saturday, going through to the end of the day, when the posters that are going to be up, you should take advantage of looking at some of the work that has been written up on the posters. We'll have the judging and the report of the posters on Saturday afternoon, and the prizes will be donated to the winners. We also are going to be having a silent auction. That will be on exhibit at the back of the room, and you'll get a chance to look at the various prizes, weekends for two, all different kinds of things, art, etc. Make your bids, and I think the final outcome of the bids will be announced on Saturday afternoon as well. For those of you who are new to the setting, at the back of the room is our internet cafe, and those of you who want to be checking on your emails, etc., that lineup of computers at the back is there for your access and use. A special welcome to our exhibitors who are in the room with us, and we look forward to a lively interaction. All we ask of them is, as soon as the lectures get going, that they close down to allow the participants to focus on what is here, and of course, they return to you during the various breaks. Special welcome to you all, and we look forward to a successful, highly interactive learning environment over the next 3 days. Now, this morning, to open our conference, we have with us the leader at the helm of our health in the country. And what better coincidence, if coincidence you may call it, that this year, in focusing on oral health, our Minister of Health is himself a specialist in oral health. We are pleased that he has been able to join us, and you can see, especially you young professionals, how well-trained our minister is. He was here on time, 9:05, because we intended to start at 9. And I want to apologize, Minister, for the slight delay in beginning, but the registration process, and there's even yet another bus on the roads. That is one thing you could pass on to your colleague, Minister of Transport. We need you to open up that bypass quickly, Minister. Do it in your regime, okay? So that we can get to Ocho Rios in, what shall it be, Solo, 45 minutes or no? We look forward to that day. I want, just before I invite Minister to give the opening welcome address and open our conference, I usually like to recognize the stalwarts who made this conference possible. People believe that I am the person who really runs this conference, and that is a misconception that I always have to defray at these meetings. Ever since 1991, and Minister, this might be of interest to you, when we started this conference at UWI, it was really an activity for the graduate students. We were developing our research program, and we said to the graduate students, we want you to bring experts in the field who can share with us. So come on board and let us plan a conference. And what gave us the further push is, I remember there was a doctor, and I'm saying this specifically means in view of what we're just discussing. There was a Dr. Winston Williams who went to the then principal of UWI and insisted that kidney dialysis should be implemented at UWI. And the then principal said to him, well, you need to educate the people about it. Why don't you put on a conference? And Dr. Williams said, but I've never done anything like that. And the principal said to him, why don't you go and talk to Morrison? He's there in diabetes, and diabetes is one of the big, you know, causes of kidney failure. See if you can join up and do something. And it was that happening along with our wanting to get our graduate students involved in bringing in experts that the conference really got off the ground. And the first 2 years, 91, 92, were held there at UWI. And since 93, we have been here at the Jamaica Grand. We have seen it pass through several ownerships. For 2 years, we went to Montego Bay, but we find that it is at the center of the island to a point, and it houses all our needs in one fell swoop. And I'm saying that because many of the students who started us in the early 90s are still here with us. Although they have graduated and gone to work in different places, some even living abroad, they apply for leave year by year and are here to work with us on this conference. And it is in that context, I see Shelley. Let's see you, Shelley. McFarlane. Thornia, the little T as we call her, who has been managing the desk out back, and a whole team of graduate students there. Where's Kushan? Kushan is somewhere in the background, and his IT support team, they're all there. These are all offshoots of the graduate students at UWI and now at UTech. They have come on board, and from time to time we get the input from the NCU as well. There is one person who is our strong anchor man over the years. I want to recognize him. He's here in the dark with a camera around his neck. He was the anchor of anatomy department for years. 40 years? 47 years. Let us recognize Salo. Come, let them see you. Salo, as he's called, and he's the cameraman, and he has pictures that go way back from when I was in short pants. Okay, so we are here. We're now ready to roll with the program. And we want to invite Minister to share with us with his opening remarks and to declare our conference open. Let me welcome Minister, the Honorable Dr. Fenton Ferguson, to the podium.
President, our chair and president of the University of Technology, distinguished members of faculty, our friends visiting from the Caribbean, United States, and Canada, students, members of the health team working across Jamaica, our sponsors of this conference present here this morning, my team of Director of Communications, Mr. Graham, the Manager of Communication, Mrs. Stephanie Shaw Smith, ladies and gentlemen. This is my second year coming to this conference, but it is significant as a second year because I became Minister of Health on the 6th of January last year. And I'm particularly pleased because what today's visit means, Professor, is that I now have 100% attendance record as minister. And I want to keep that record even as you have started this conference almost 21 years ago. But I'm particularly pleased to be here this year because of the mix, the links between diabetes and oral health. And I want to say a special hello to the students of dental surgery and other members of the dental team who are at UTech now pursuing their course of study for being here this morning and this special and historic morning. Because, Professor, oral health has not in the past been given the kind of prominence that it deserves. And in recognizing us as a part of the medical team. And as history would have it, I am extremely pleased to become, having become the first dental surgeon to be the Minister of Health. And so, ladies and gentlemen and students, I am declaring that I want history to remember me well, not just for what I would have done for health, but also for bringing oral health to where it deserves to be. And so I want to congratulate you, Professor, and your team for making this connection this year. I think this conference is a very, very important one on the calendar of events. It brings to the table an opportunity for bringing together our Caribbean neighbors. And I am one who believes that Caribbean integration is not just a political process. It must be seen, as was demonstrated with the University of the West Indies in its early days, it must be seen in the context of how we continue in the process of cross-fertilization of ideas and how we use whatever it is. Next year it will be sports, tying in with the diabetes program. But this is an instrument to bring us closer and closer together. And I'm very happy that our friends coming out of Canada, United States, and elsewhere are also here sharing with us. I had early introductions, and from those introductions, it is very clear that the persons we have visiting with us at this conference are persons with distinguished records of performance, experience in oral health, well-known administrators in health. And so there's much that we have to benefit from their presence. I also want to say a word as it relates to persons who have exhibits here and sponsors, because these conferences are, as all of us know, very expensive. And it is not always easy to sustain them for 20 and more years. And therefore, while there might be vested interests, it is always good to see the sponsors coming out and supporting, and at the same time bringing to the table the possibilities for health. I want to congratulate you and to ask that you continue to support this worthwhile program. Again, ladies and gentlemen, I see that there are persons who should have also come in from as far as Holland, Puerto Rico. That's great. I do believe, ladies and gentlemen, that this is a strategic moment to bring together in Ocho Rios one of our popular vacation spots to have this conference. We also, from time to time, love to take in the cool breeze and the warmth of the Jamaican people and sun. So this is a perfect staycation for us to work while we educate ourselves. I hope that our visits and our visitors can also get some time to enjoy our offerings here in Jamaica at the end of the conference. We are open for business and for pleasure, and would love to see you again soon with your family and friends, to whom I'm sure you will brag about when you return from this trip. Once again, we are grateful for you being in our country. Ladies and gentlemen, we find ourselves at a crossroad where non-communicable diseases are concerned. In the last 3 decades, we were concerned with communicable diseases such as HIV and AIDS, along with other STIs, but within the last decade, we have found ourselves in the midst of another epidemic. The epidemiological shift has brought us front and center of a serious challenge where non-communicable diseases, including diabetes, are concerned. This is not just a problem for the region, it is a global issue. According to the World Health Organization, in 2008, 36 million or 63% of deaths globally were due to NCDs, of which 80% or 29 million occurred in low and middle income countries, such as Jamaica. Also in low and middle income countries, 29% of the NCD deaths occur among people under the age of 60. In 2020, deaths from NCD is expected to increase to 44 million. The NCD's landscape in Jamaica is just as troubling and frightening. Non-communicable diseases, including diabetes, are responsible for approximately 60% of deaths in Jamaica. The figures for diabetes, which represents one of the major NCDs, also paint a troubling picture. The International Diabetes Federation described diabetes mellitus as one of the most challenging health problems in the 21st century and one of the most common non-communicable diseases globally, ranking fourth or fifth as the leading cause of death in most high-income countries and an epidemic in many economically developing and newly industrialized countries. According to the IDF, 366 million people had diabetes in 2011. By 2030, this will have risen to 552 million. The number of people with type 2 diabetes is increasing in every country. 80% of people with diabetes live in low and middle-income countries. The greatest number of people with diabetes are between 40 and 59 years. 78,000 children develop type 1 diabetes every year. 183 million, or 50% of persons with diabetes, are undiagnosed. Diabetes caused 4.6 million deaths in 2011. In addition to the high mortality, data shows that diabetes is associated with high morbidity, including ischemic heart disease, stroke, peripheral vascular disease, amputation, eye disease, renal disease, peripheral neuropathy. The prevalence of diabetes mellitus in Jamaica is now estimated at 7.9% among persons between 15 and 74 years old. In addition, 2.8% of the population has impaired fasting glucose. Diabetes is a major cause of morbidity and mortality in Jamaica and was ranked as the leading cause of death among women and the third leading cause of death for men in 2009. The focus of this conference on diabetes is therefore not coincidental. Neither is this year's theme, diabetes and oral health, as we all know the significant role that oral health plays in efforts to reduce the prevalence of NCDs, including diabetes. It is time that we begin to strategically use this tool to assist with mending the problems we have had, especially with respect to early detection and control of these diseases. There is a significant body of evidence that have empirically demonstrated an important and strong relationship between oral health and diabetes. Oral health and care practitioners have observed significant periodontal changes that have aided in the diagnosis and management of diabetes, as certain oral health conditions are the first manifestation of the disease. A study conducted in 2011 by Choi, McKeown, and Mayor Davis et al., which looked at the association between periodontitis and impaired fasting glucose and diabetes, confirmed what we all have known, that there is indeed a significant link between diabetes and periodontal disease. To better understand the relationship between oral health and elevated blood glucose, the researchers assessed the periodontal health and fasting plasma glucose levels of more than 12,000 participants. The team found that diabetes was most prevalent in the group with the most serious periodontitis. And there was also a strong correlation between pre-diabetes and periodontitis. From the findings, the researchers made two important observations. One, that screening for periodontal disease, along with a concerted effort to improve and maintain oral health, may be particularly important, not only for people with diabetes, but also for those with pre-diabetes. Secondly, because periodontitis is now clearly known to be a risk factor for elevated blood glucose levels, it may be advisable that people with the disease to consider testing for undiagnosed diabetes or pre-diabetes. It stands to reason that we place close attention to oral health and diabetes. In fact, the UN Political Declaration on NCDs recognizes that oral diseases pose a major health burden and can benefit from common responses to the non-communicable diseases. This highlights the need to forge partnership with every sector and the vital role oral health practitioners have to play in the reduction of the prevalence of non-communicable diseases. Every health worker, including doctors and dental surgeons, will have to view the patient in a holistic way and in congruence with other specializations. In Jamaica, oral diseases and conditions are important public health concerns because of their high prevalence, severity, public demand for services, and because of their impact on individuals and society. This government has been paying keen attention in this regard. We are on a drive to develop oral health services across the island, especially in underserved rural communities. Among the plans are the development of a relevant and modern legal framework to govern and regulate oral health services. This began with the appointment of new dental council, dental auxiliary council body, and the dental appeal tribunal. This in addition to the establishment of minimum standards of care for oral health. The deepening of the integration of oral health care into all services offered at the health centers. This will allow us to focus on vulnerable communities and at-risk groups. Of importance also is the alignment of oral health goals with the national health goals, which will strengthen oral health services delivery while maintaining the gains. And therefore, this will also put an emphasis on dental health in our promotion and education programs. As a dental surgeon, I am well aware of the challenges facing oral health services in Jamaica, and I am committed to making a mark in this area as health minister. I am not in the business of making promises that I cannot keep. My legacy must be one based on trust, hard work, smart work, and results. I am therefore doing everything to make a meaningful change in the lives of the Jamaican people. The information coming out of this conference can help us to further understand the linkages between oral health and diabetes, and therefore lead to evidence-based policies and programs that can assist in reducing the prevalence of this disease among the population. I am interested in the presentations that will allow us to understand and learn from the experiences of our other countries in dealing with diabetes and oral health challenges. I also note the importance of the topic for Sir Alistair McIntyre's distinguished lecture, "How Partnership in the Fight Against Diabetes and Oral Disease Will Benefit Society." I am a strong proponent of establishing partnerships in every area of healthcare, as this is the only way that we'll be able to make any meaningful change. The strategic plan on NCDs in Jamaica 2012 to 2017 has as one of its main pillars a whole of society approach and the need to engage all stakeholders in the fight against NCDs. I am happy that this conference is highlighting this in such a major way. We have a difficult, but not impossible road ahead. But I'm hopeful when I see the opportunities like this, where we can partner and draw attention to the needs to improve the state of our health, that we will be able to make gains both personally and from a national standpoint. I thank the University of Technology, Jamaica, the University of the West Indies, UDOP, the Diabetes Association of Jamaica, the Jamaica Association of Public Dental Surgeons, our guests from overseas, as well as all the other partners for being a part of this important forum and recognizing the importance of placing oral health squarely on the agenda in efforts to combat NCDs. I wish you all the best for a meaningful and productive session and look forward to receiving the report from this meeting to assist us as we seek to put in place evidence-based policies and programs. It is therefore for me, Professor Morrison, indeed a great pleasure to declare this conference officially open.
I thank you.
Minister, we're so thankful for that address. And students, I hope you're taking copious notes, because Professor McKenzie assures me that you'll all have a test at the end of the day. But Minister, you said you intend to leave a legacy. The dental school is beside the children's hospital. And your strongest support in the ministry, your chief dental officer, Professor McKenzie, upon whom this whole development rests, wants a legacy as well. Need I say more, sir? We're right beside the children's hospital. We have a vision. And in expressing that vision, I just want to recognize Associate Professor Winston Gray, who just came in, also one of the anchors of the development of the dental program here at UTech. Special welcome to you, sir. And in just mentioning the outreach to children that we want to see, I want to just spend a few minutes, Minister, to invite the Diabetes Association reps, Mr. Owen Bernard and Shelley McFarlane, to tell you briefly about an outreach to children and an outcome, and to ask you, Minister, to hand out a few prizes for them. Mr. Owen Bernard, Executive Director of the Diabetes Association, welcome to the podium.
Thank you, Professor Morrison. Minister of Health, the Honorable Dr. Fenton Ferguson, Professor the Honorable Errol Morrison, President, University of Technology, father of this conference. It gives me great pleasure to make an announcement. 2 years ago, the World Diabetes Foundation funded a project, a pilot project, which speaks to the management of diabetes in youth, children, adolescents, age 0 to 24. We were required to develop protocols and guidelines. As you know, management of diabetes just speaks to the clinical aspect to it. There is more to it. There's a social component, the everyday living. Three countries involved: Belize, Jamaica, and St. Lucia. Jamaica was required to register 1,200 children that for our youngsters, adolescents, that falls within that age group. A year ago, it was reported that there are over 10,000 youngsters within that age group out there with diabetes. Where are they? We need to find them. No child should suffer anymore for the lack of insulin, because there is a project that deals with that as well. The WDF 10573 speaks to the development of the protocols and guidelines. What we did, the project was fraught with a lot of problems. This is in collaboration, the program is in collaboration, Diabetes Association of Jamaica, Ministry of Health, a lot of people involved. What we did was to give an incentive. The region that would register the highest number. And it gives me great pleasure to announce that the Western region was the region that registered and recorded the highest number within that age group. Now, two prizes we decided to give out: a laptop and a notebook. The notebook we decided to give to the individual or an individual who walked the grounds went into the communities and identified these people. I would like to call Mrs. Brown Williams, who is a CHA, am I correct, to come forward. I would like to invite the Honorable Minister to do the honors of presenting the prize. The other prize, I would like to invite Dr. Spence from the Western region, am I correct? Correct me if I'm wrong, to come forward to receive the next prize. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Even though the project has come to an end, it continues because there's capacity building and it will continue because there are a lot more youngsters out there with diabetes that we need to identify and bring them into the fold. Thank you.